There's different ways to use tape. They all start out pretty much the same way. Let me show you the beginning of it. You start with the tape about even here, and then you work your way up. And we want this hollow tube above the end of the wire, like this. So they got this flexy part. Gonna fold that over, and then we basically go the opposite direction. And so we'll have a cap, if you will, of tape over the end of there. Now at this point, there's a couple different ways to finish it. Let me show you those, or at least three different ways to finish it. One way is to just simply tuck the tape in between the legs, pull it tight, and be done with it, and fold it back in there and be done with it, stretch it tight. Another way is when you do this, when you put the tape through the legs, give yourself a lot of extra space and use that to create a knot in here. So what we're going to do is we're going to wet this, and quickly before the water dries out, we're going to tie a knot around this leg like this. This is what they used to do in old cars. They used black tape, but it didn't have any adhesive on it, and they would do this technique and then just pull it tight before it dries. And drying. Ah, there we go. Okay, and you have this tail here. You cut the tail off. And the tape will stay there without unraveling. And another way to do this is to start out with the same technique. Tape roughly at the top. Tape upward. Give yourself that little bit of empty tape up there at the top. Fold it over. Start back down the other way. And here's where we can choose to tie it off or whatever. Let me get some scissors and cut this. When I try to break it with my hand, the camera shakes, so like that. And from here, you can do something like cover this with shrink wrap, like this. And you'll have a nice, nice, relatively watertight joint. Not 100%, but pretty good. And here we are with our shrink wrap positioned and shrunk down. And you can see the electric tape in there, and that will hold the electric tape in position, and it will make a nice sound insulated joint. When taping an inline splice, I typically start about the width of the tape away and start wrapping it tightly around. In fact, if you can stretch it, that's better. Put a little stretch to the tape. Make sure there's no sharp points in your joint that will going to poke through the tape. If there are, take them down with pliers, file, whatever it takes to smooth them down. You can use multiple wraps to give you more electrical and mechanical protection. And wrap well past the joint, again at least the width of the tape. Most people will stop here. What I prefer to do is carry it out, and we're going to wet the tail of the tape, and we're going to tie a knot in it quickly before it dries, like this. Pull it taut over the end. It's drying out here a little bit. And snip the tail off. And that wrapping won't come loose as easily as just ending the tape and leaving the adhesive to do the work. A method that I've really learned to like is starting out with a tape. Again, same rules apply. Stretch the tape out. Cover the joint well. Make sure there's no points in it that are going to stick up through the tape. Tape the joint. And if I need to, go back over it a couple times. Okay. So I may end up with a thick joint, but that's okay. So now I've got something that's well covered. But in order to give it some, yeah, a little better looks, whatever, and to hold the tape in place over a longer period of time, I prefer now to finish it out with a piece of shrink wrap like this, and it produces a very secure joint, a very secure covering on the joint, and it won't come off there, the tape won't come off of there. But because I'm using tape, I can build up a more insulation, build up a thicker insulation around the joint and make it more secure, and in the end make it a little bit better looking and a little more professional looking. So a combination of tape and shrink wrap is now my preferred method of doing things most of the time. Another technique in shrink wrapping is to use multiple layers of shrink wrap. So let's do that. I've got a joint I want to cover. I want to make sure that the insulation is thick over that area for abrasion purposes or, you know, whatever. And then I just slide another piece over the top of it, outside of it, and shrink that one down. Also, if I have a thin joint right here and thick insulation and I don't want to show the bulge or the dip going in here, I can put a piece of shrink wrap that just fits in that gap, shrink it down there, and then put another piece over the top of it to make the wire look smooth. Again, that's just for aesthetics, but it works. Okay, let's tape a three-way joint. We'll start like we do in an inline joint. And I'm going to go this way. I'm going to move the wire just because it's a little easier to keep something fixed. And I'm going to tape towards the center joint. Now, one of the tricks is I got to keep something from going in here and making contact, so I got to protect this where this joint comes off. So I'm going to tape right up against the yellow wire, the extension. I'm going to go around like this, and keeping it tight. And now I'm going to go right where this angle is, and I'm going to go across here like this. And you see now I've got this protected in here like that. Come up around again, I'm going to go protect the other side like that. Okay, so now I've got both of these protected. Come up here like this, change directions, and I'm going to go around the yellow wire to make sure I protect it. Go up a bit. It would be more beautiful if my tape weren't wrinkled. Keeping it tight. Okay, enough. Back down. I still have to go back and tape this side. So, go down. I've already protected here, I've already protected here. Now I just need to finish this out. Make sure I get insulation, adequate insulation along here. Like that. Now I can go back and do this multiple times if I need more protection on the wire, on the joint. And typically, I'll either tie it off, like on the others, or add the shrink wrap to, it doesn't have to be this big, but just a piece of shrink wrap here to lock the tape in place. So that's it, taping up a three-way joint. One common mistake when shrink wrapping is when you're preparing the piece of shrink wrap, you may leave a little cut in it. Maybe you didn't separate entirely, so you pull on it, tear a little bit, and there's just like a little tiny cut here. And let's see what happens when we go to shrink wrap this. See, the split will open. If you're lucky, it will stop. Sometimes it'll just continue to split down the length. The only way to do it is either cut it all the way off and re-prepare it. Sometimes you can take a razor blade, and if you're very careful, cut around here in a nice circle. Again, make sure you don't leave a kind of a hanging cut when you do it, and peel that bad spot off, but of course then you lose a little bit of your space. So again, a common mistake, if you leave a cut or nick in the shrink wrap, it can open up and it can also propagate down here quite a bit more.